My name is Beelieve. I am an emote artist, a variety streamer, and gamer. I'm going to show you how to implement the browser source into your OBS program. I'm going to show you how you can use the extension, and we are also going to add and manage some sounds so you guys are all set to use this on your own streams. So let's get started with adding your browser source in your OBS program. After logging in, this is what the sound alerts dashboard looks like. And there you can choose which tool you're using. I will show you how to implement the browser source using OBS Studio. So that's what I click. This button says drag and drop me into OBS. And this is super easy to do. Go ahead, open up OBS program. I'm going to put them side by side so that it's easier to see. Make sure you select the scene that you want to add this to. And then simply drag and drop this button into OBS. It doesn't matter where you release. You can release it anywhere as long as your mouse is above the program. It will ask you if you want to create this source. You hit yes, and here's the browser source automatically created. As always, you can move this around and adjust it where you want it. Quick tip, make sure that this is above all your other sources so that when it plays on stream, it won't be obstructed by anything. Make sure it's at the very top of your source list. In case you're not using OBS Studio, but a different program for streaming, you will want to click on I use something else in this setup. It will show you a hidden URL that you can use to set up that browser source in any other streaming program. Make sure you don't share this information. You don't even have to show the URL. You can just click on this little symbol right here to copy the URL into your clipboard. With that link copied, you want to go to your streaming program. If you're using something like Streamlabs OBS, this will be very similar to what it looks like here in OBS. Navigate to the scene you want to add the browser source to, and then find the Add Source button. It's important to select the browser source for this. Then you can give it a name and simply paste the URL with Control V up here in the very top field. You can hit OK and the browser source should be ready to go. If there ever is a problem with one of your browser sources, the first thing you want to do is to refresh it. So right-click your source and go to Properties. If you scroll down, you can see this refresh button down here, and that helps in my experience in like 90% of the cases when there's any problems with the browser source. You just want to hit a refresh and it will help you if it ever becomes stuck or there's something else going on. This should be the first thing you try. Another useful settings in the properties is the box that says control audio via OBS. If you hit this, control the audio via OBS and you hit OK, now you will notice that the sound alerts are added as an audio source in the mixer. If it's too loud, for example, you can adjust that in your OBS by bringing it down here. You can also mute all of the alerts by clicking on this button. An important tip to make sure that both you and the viewer can hear the sound alerts when they're playing is to go into the settings on this little wheel down here. So in the sound alerts source in the audio mixer, click on the little settings button. You will find advanced audio properties right there. Click on that and make sure that the sound alerts are set to monitor and output right here. Then hit close and the audio should play for both your viewers and yourself. So if you have multiple scenes, let me just add scene 2 to my OBS. If you have multiple scenes and you still want the sound alerts to show up in all of your scenes that you're using, what you should do is right-click the browser source that you have already added and hit copy. Go to the other scene, right-click in the source window and hit paste. You can also use Control C and Control V for this. You'll see that it copied the browser source, and in both of my scenes, there now are sound alerts in here. This is important to avoid problems with your sources, and it also makes it super easy if you ever have to change the URL and you do it in scene 1, it will automatically also happen in scene 2. Once the browser source is set up, you can go to your dashboard and hit play test alert to see what it would look like and to see if everything works. Let's try it.
Hey, Kappa Kappa, hey, Kappa Kappa, hey.
Works. So the browser source is working pretty well. Let's have a look at the Twitch extension. The second step of your setup will be to install the Twitch extension. The Sound Alerts Twitch extension is a widget you can use on your stream, and it makes it really easy for your viewers to use bits to play sounds live on stream. Just click on Install Extension, and it will take you to the extension page on Twitch, where you can install it right here. It will ask you if you want to configure the settings, but this is no longer needed. You can find all of the relevant settings in the new Sound Alerts web app now. So now that the extension is installed, you want to head over to the Extensions tab in your Creator dashboard. If you hit My Extensions, you can see all of the ones you have installed. Sound Alerts is right here. The next step is to activate your Sound Alerts extension. There are different ways you can set this up. You can choose to set it up as a component, which shows up and lets viewers interact with it directly on top of your stream. Or you can set it up as a panel, which shows up and lets the viewers interact with it underneath the stream when they scroll down a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and set it as a panel for my own stream. So now it should show up here in your activated extensions and it is ready to go. So with the browser source in OBS all set up and the extension installed, the last thing you should take care of is adding and managing some sounds. So let's have a look at that. Clicking on Library will take you to all of the options you have with the sound files. As you can see, there are a lot of sounds already here in this library. You can use the search function to see if there's something already here that you would like to use. You can also upload your own sounds and manage them here. You can mark some favorites and you will find them over here as well. I'm gonna go ahead and upload a custom sound by hitting Upload and then browsing my File Explorer, selecting the one I want and opening it, give it a name and select the mood that it has, upload sound file here at the bottom. So that sound is now uploaded successfully. We could go ahead and add another one, but for now, let's just have a look in uploads. We can see our custom sound right here. So if you want to allow viewers to play this sound live on stream, we have to click Add This Sound. First, let's add it using the extension. Here you can rename the sound and decide how many bits it is worth. Then hit Add Sound and the program will automatically add this to the extension that we have set up earlier. Let's go ahead and add it also as a reward for channel points, which viewers automatically get when they watch your stream. Here you can also rename the sound and decide how many channel points it is going to cost. Go ahead and press Add Sound, and that's it. So here we can see that in the extension, the goat scream has been added for 500 bits. And in the channel points, we find a reward for Sound Alert Goat Scream right here. If you click on the Sounds tab to the left, it takes you to a very useful page that lets you manage all of the sounds you already added. You can easily edit all the sounds here, change the name, change the bits, change the volume. You can make it sub only, remove them. You can also preview. And the same goes for all the sound alerts that you have added using channel points. And it's super easy to change all of these settings here as well. I hope that this was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.